I connect 12 volts to the input of the circuit, the same as the city electricity entrance. The power input is 12 volts and the circuit is working. Let's do this together. Hi, how can we convert a switching power supply to a 220 volt power inverter? This is a simple power supply that you must have used many times. As you know, the electricity voltage of the city enters from here. It is rectified by the diode bridge and is stored in the capacitors. This circuit uses half-bridge topology. IC creates PWM pulses. These pulses are amplified with the help of these two transistors, and it reaches these two main transistors through the pulse transformer. The voltage in the capacitors reaches the transformer in an intermittent manner with the help of these two transistors. The transformer of this circuit is stepped down. According to the number of turns of the secondary winding, the voltage decreases. It is then rectified by Schottky diode. This voltage enters the capacitors and its ripples is eliminated. So, we will have a smooth voltage at the output, which is usually 12 volt DC in this type of circuit. So, the main job of the power supply is to convert the high voltage of AC into the required voltage of DC. We want to convert this device to a 220 volt power inverter without making many changes to the circuit. As I said before, this transformer is a step down. That is, it converts the 220 volt city electricity to 12 volt. Of course, I mean this circuit. The first thing is to remove this transformer from the circuit. Then, we have to use the secondary and primary parts in reverse. It means to enter low voltage in the transformer and get high voltage in the output section. In addition to removing the transformer, we have to make two small changes in the circuit so that this device can function as 220 volt power inverter. There is no need to separate any part except the transformer. By removing the changes, you can use this device as a switching power supply again. All we need to do is turn on the IC to generate the pulse. Because normally, the voltage needed to start the IC is provided through the auxiliary coil. So, when we remove the transformer, there is no auxiliary coil to generate the required voltage of the IC. I show the changes on another circuit. These two circuits are identical. I took out the transformer. I don't take out any part except the transformer, because we want to use the device as a power supply again later. There are two things we need to do. The diode bridge output has positive and negative voltage. I connect the negative of the diode bridge to pin 7 of the IC. The number of this IC is TL494 or KB7500. They are not different from each other. We connect the positive output of the diode bridge to pin 12 of the IC or VCC. You can use any way. I use the diode bridge pins to make it better visible in the video. Next, we have to connect the capacitor pins of the short circuit to each other. I mean this capacitor. I posted a video for the short circuit in the channel and explained the working of this circuit along with the schematic. So, we connected the capacitor pins together. The reason for this is that pin 4 of the ICTL494 must have a voltage close to 0 volt, so that the dead time between pulses is minimal. Now, how can we use transformer? There is a line in the circuit that separates the hot and cold part of the circuit. The hot section has high voltage. There are only two pins related to the transformer in the hot part of the circuit. I only use these two pins. I solder two wires here. We will connect this wire to the transformer later. We have to use this transformer in reverse. These pins are located near the resonance capacitor. So, Their location is known. This capacitor can be either MKT or polyester. The function of this capacitor is to prevent the DC voltage from entering the transformer and also to create a resonance mode. We no longer do anything on a circuit. We just need to connect the transformer. We can open the transformer and making the necessary changes. But I don't intend to destroy the device. I use another transformer. At the end of the video, I will tell you how to use the main transformer of the device without damaging it. This is a 220 volt LED lamp. I use a computer power supply transformer. In this transformer, there are several outputs for 12, 3, and 5 volts. Often a pin is also considered as common. Connect the lamp on the side where there are fewer outlets. We try different pins. Now, I connect 12 volts to the circuit. Then, I will connect the wire to the transformer to see which pin has the best light. Here is the entrance to the city electricity. I connect the positive and negative voltage here. There is no difference between the positive and negative directions because it is located in the path of the diode bridge. Let's measure the voltage first. The multimeter is in DC mode. We have approximately 12 volts. As much as we increase the input voltage, the light of the lamp increases. But we should not increase the input voltage more than 30 volts because the IC will burn. We do not connect the output of the transformer that produces high voltage to the circuit anymore because it will damage the feedback circuit and burst the capacitors. Now, I will try to see which one has better light. Well, these two are the best of all. Let's look inside the lamp. Remember that this circuit cannot produce good power at this low voltage. I wanted to show you that by knowing how the circuit works, any changes can be made to it. There is another method. You can prepare the primary winding by yourself, like this. Two turns are enough. Now, I use this transformer. I connect the output of the circuit to the coil that we prepared ourselves. This has good light. I increase the input voltage. About 20 volts. Now we have good light. If we want to use the main transformer of the device, we must put two turns of wire. Get output from these two pins. The same two pins that are located next to the resonance capacitor. Since this circuit is in the form of a half bridge, it cannot generate much power with an input voltage of 12 volts. Do not increase the input voltage too much because the IC and amplifier transistor will burn. Thank you for liking and thank you for watching.